Hey guys, Ivan here, and welcome to another video. This video we are starting with Anton Ratushnyi, who just won his classic physique pro card at a very, very extremely young age of 19. Only 19 freaking years old, he's already a pro. I mean, this is insane. He actually won his pro card at the NPC Nationals, which is arguably the toughest amateur show in the world. So he didn't only win his pro card by winning the class, because there were two pro cards in his class given, the first and the second spot. He also won the classic physique overall, guys, classic physique overall at the age of 19. This makes him the youngest classic physique IFBB pro, the youngest guy to ever win the overall at the NPC Nationals, and I think this also makes him the youngest IFBB pro ever. There is only one guy that also turned pro at 19, and that's Jeff Seid, but he was in men's physique, and that was the early days of men's physique, so it didn't require that much. Classic physique exists for a long time, and it's extremely competitive, especially nowadays. And NPC Nationals is known as the toughest amateur show in the world, in the NPC. I'm not necessarily saying that the competition in this show was the toughest ever, but once again, NPC Nationals is known as the biggest amateur show in the world. He didn't win his pro card at some show that nobody knows. He won this show and he won the overall of this show. And this is all crazy for a 19-year-old to turn pro like this. This is definitely way more impressive than what Jeff did. So in my opinion, this is the youngest IFBB professional bodybuilder of all time. Cody Montgomery did something also very close, probably even more impressive. He turned pro at the age of 20, but he was open bodybuilding, you know, bodybuilding. It wasn't classic physique, so, you know, he did probably more. That's probably more impressive, but he still was 20. After all, he wasn't 19, so the youngest bodybuilder to ever turn pro is, it's gotta be Anton Ratushnyi. And this is his physique right now. In my opinion, he has so much potential. It's crazy that, you know, usually when these guys have crazy genetics like this, they usually don't look mature enough at the young age. You know, they look like they have the potential to grow, and they usually, you know, end up in open bodybuilding. But this guy already looks very proportionate, very, very classic at that young age, and he has the maturity also. He has that, you know, hard, gnarly look. He already has it. It's not like he needs to work on that. All he needs to add, really, is muscle. Like, that's all. He just needs to keep growing, and only on the right places. He needs to maintain the waist size. He needs to do it, you know, nice and slow, so he doesn't ruin his lines, because everything else is there. Yeah, sure, he needs to work on his posing as well, but, I mean, this is actually pretty good for a 19-year-old, so in time, everything is simply going to get better. Once again, his physique already has that maturity. You can see it right here, for example, so his glutes are peeled, you know, super hard, as well as his lower back. I mean, look at the Christmas tree. His conditioning, too, was really good at this show, so he knows how to get peeled. He has the classic lines. Sure, he's gonna perfect the posing, but it's already very good, so overall, this guy has so much potential, and eventually, someday, he might be the one to replace Chris Bumstead. We'll see. Also, I gotta say, it's very interesting that this guy turned pro basically a week after I made a video about the top bodybuilders who are not pros yet and why are they not pros. And I predicted this guy is gonna win a pro card very soon. And so it happened. If you guys haven't watched that video, go back. It's like a week old video. Check it out. As far as the NPC Nationals overall bodybuilding winner, it's this guy right here. His name is Trevor Birch, and he's your new IFBB pro. Alright, next we got a posing video of Samson Dauda, and guys, he looks like he blew up, big time. I have no idea what the hell did he do, but look at him right now, he looks so freaking huge. You're gonna see the other poses, it's a full posing routine, everything looks so much bigger, so much fuller. This is insane, this looks like freaking Ronnie Coleman in the off-season. I mean, check out this side chest right here at 12 weeks out of Arnold Classic, as he says. He looks like he gained, I don't know, 30 pounds, and the conditioning is still there. He doesn't look any less conditioned. Let me actually show you the video. I really feel like he's gonna come to the Arnold Classic much bigger and better than ever before. I think it's gonna be a huge difference from the Mr. Olympia to Arnold. because from the Arnold to Mr. Olympia, it wasn't that much big of a difference, and you know, usually he does make a lot of progress from show to show. Maybe I shouldn't say that way, maybe I should say so far he has been making a lot of progress from show to show, because maybe that is over. I mean, he's not gonna make that much progress forever. Maybe he reached the maximum potential, but I don't know, because look at this. And honestly, I'm more impressed by the transitions from this video than the actual poses. I mean, look at this transition, this moment. Look at how big he is. I mean, this is looking like Ronnie Coleman with smaller waist, with smaller back and some other body parts, but and definitely much less shredded glutes. But as far as the size, the shape, the proportions, it's probably as close as it gets. I'm not saying he's going to surpass Ronnie Coleman or get to his level, but he is the closest guy right now, definitely. But once again, pay attention to how much bigger he is right now than he was at the Mr. Olympia. He blew up, and the conditioning is there, look at the glutes. So he's still very lean, very dry, he's not even watery, and look at the freaking shape, the roundness, the size. Like, he is enormously big right now. I really hope they're gonna manage to keep him this big and full. And, I mean, not much leaner, really. He doesn't need to be much leaner than this. Now look at the back also. Like, that's his weakest point, but it's not that weak. Not anymore. It's not really that weak. It's actually a pretty decent back. Sure, back double can be bigger, can be better, but back lat spread? I mean, look at this. Look at when he opens up. How much better, how much wider does it get? Like, this is very, very good. Like, at this point, I don't think he needs to improve that back much more. He's very, very thick. I mean, look at the back from the side. Like, it's popping out. So he has a lot of muscle in that back. A little bit higher lats, but I think that's fine. And look at the fullness from the side. Like, he's so freaking thick. The chest, the shoulders, the arms, the back from the side. And what's crazy with all this muscle, with all this mass, a very small waist, a good midsection. Definitely one of the most impressive bodybuilders of today. I want to see this guy win the Mr. Olympia. I know what he needs to do. I see why he didn't win it this year. Check out this most muscular, guys. This is insane. This is crazy. I can see why he didn't win, and that's mainly, I would put it this way, it's because he needs to get bigger. As crazy as it sounds, yeah, because like he didn't look bigger than Hadi and Derek on stage pound for pound. Yeah, he's 300 pounds on stage and the other guys are like 230, so he's much heavier, but you know, it's because of his height mainly. These guys are much, much shorter, so they're actually probably packing more muscle on their frames, or at least the same. Probably more, I would say. And they're more conditioned. So I think Samson needs to get a little bit bigger and a little bit more conditioned. And then his frame, his height is going to be an advantage. And he can actually pull a win. I think he can do it. I mean, look at this freaking most muscular. This is insane. Now imagine this with super crazy conditioning. And maybe a little bit more muscle. A little bit more maturity. A little bit more details everywhere. Yeah, yeah, I can see this guy becoming the Mr. Olympia winner, maybe even as soon as next year. I don't know, what do you guys think? Tell me down below. Alright, next we got a little physique update of Antoine Vaillant, who is also doing the Arnold Classic in 12 weeks from now. So he's gonna be doing this show with Samson, with James Hollingshead, who is also commenting on this photo, and a bunch of other great guys. Definitely not a top contender, but you know, always has a really good, very interesting routine, and he has some good body parts, like his legs can get really freaky. He is a very popular guy on social media. I like him, I like his personality, but as far as him as a competitive bodybuilder at this Arnold Classic, definitely not a top threat. Now, you're probably wondering what his health is like, and he spoke about this on a podcast. Basically, it's much better. It's much better. His doctor told him that he can compete for another couple of years without any issues. He says everything else, as far as his blood work, his EKG, all the tests are perfect. He seems very, very healthy and he can continue competing. So he's going to be doing this Arnold Classic and probably a couple of shows after that. I think he qualified for the Mr. Olympia 2 times so far, and I'm sure he can do it again if he chooses the show wisely. And that's gonna do it for this video, guys. Tell me, what do you think about this new pro that we got Anton Ratushnyi. What do you think his potential future is in classic physique? Make sure to let me know down below in the comment section, guys. If you enjoyed this video, please like it. If you want to see more, subscribe. Thank you so much for watching. See you soon. All the best and bye-bye.